So, aliens vs. Predator. Take the two most deadliest species known in the galaxy, throw in a little humans, and you've got a recipe for some badassery, right? How could anybody f that up? Damn it! It's a damn shame that you can't talk about AVP now without mentioning the terrible movies. You have to force yourself to find things that you like in them if you're a hardcore fan. At least the second one has a little bit more gore and it has kind of early Marine. No! No! Do not do that! We must nuke him from orbit. It's the only way to be sure. Don't understand why Hollywood has to screw everything up. Why didn't they just stick with the excellent comics? Don't they see that the essential ingredient to all those movies are missing, the Colonial Marine? It would have been an infinitely better movie and one that we could all be proud of. The only justice that this series has seen done to it is in those comic books, and thankfully, a few games. AVP on the Jaguar and the PC in 94 and 99 by Rebellion, and AVP 2 in 2001 by Monolith. Well, finally, everybody, we got a new Aliens vs. Predator game. So is this new Aliens vs. Predator closer to those disappointing movies, or does it bring back memories of nostalgia and help vault this franchise into the future? Let's find out. Back in the hands of the developer that brought the original game to life, this new Aliens vs. Predator seems very familiar. The game offers the same three campaign setup, and it took me about 13 to 14 hours to complete, which is pretty good for an FPS as of late. But it could have been because I did a lot of the extra collection hunting. And take note, everybody else, if you're gonna be using these audio tapes as cheap collectibles, then you damn well better be sure that the voice acting is top-notch and that the history of the story is interesting to learn about, which it is here.
Even now, I can't help but admire her, despite all she did to hold us back. Three times she faced them. Three times she obstructed our progress. She showed us strength that few possess. If she had only realized the magnificence of what she had sought to destroy.
As expected, the Marine and Predator campaigns are excellent. The Marine campaign in particular starts off really exciting, and plus you get this cute little tough Latina hottie, Tequila.
Good job, rookie. I guess we're even. How's the head? Come on in and grab yourself a pulse rifle, kid.
Who reminds me of the awesome Vasquez.
I only need to know one thing, where they are.
While the Predator campaign allows us to see more of the inner workings of all of their rituals and to see a lot of their advanced technology from the inside. But again, the Alien campaign is the weakest of the three. It's so frustrating that they can't put together an interesting story for the Xenomorphs. Now the story starts off strong, but besides a little bit where they capture and trap you, it just kind of just goes through the motions. And I think some of the problem comes from the three stories being tied together. And they don't have to do this. In fact, I feel a stronger story could have been obtained if the Alien and the Predator campaigns weren't tied down to the Marines. Imagine for a second playing as an alien in a genocide war, red versus black, where the origins of your species is discovered, and the two forces fight each other over a space jockey ship. Or how about a Predator campaign, where a banished loose cannon Predator decides to regain his honor by killing the ultimate foe in the galaxy. With nothing else to lose, he travels to the alien homeworld to claim the skull of an empress. Hey, all those ideas are free for the next game, Rebellion. use them. Which reminds me, AVP does suffer from the I'm a little cocky so I'm gonna set up the sequel in the ending of the first game syndrome. But in this case, the hook is very interesting if it actually does happen. We'll have to see.
That's it, man. Game over, man. It's game over. What the fuck are we gonna do now? What are we gonna do?
Now, a lot of people have complained about the graphics. I think they look great in the cutscenes. But admittedly, they are pretty rough in all other areas. However, she makes up for it in the audio department. Some of the iconic sounds are recreated perfectly here. And there's that pulse-pounding, downright scary soundtrack. The part where issues start to creep in is within the game design itself. You wonder why there's no iron sight for Marines, why their jump is worthless, why the maps feel restricted, and more importantly, why no risks were taken at all. Oh, and I gotta call bull. The developer promised a new alien type.
One of the fun things at the games, I believe even in the comic books as well, is people played around. I think the one that remembers is the Pred Alien, you know, from the hybrid of the two. Yeah. Are we seeing some of those classic ones? Have you guys even experimented more with some of the alien classes?
There will be one or two surprises in the game. Some things we've introduced, but you know, you mentioned the Pred Alien. The Pred Alien does indeed feature in the game, and is and yeah, there are one or two other alien surprises in there, but I'm not going to reveal those yet.
No, but I want to be scared myself. I have to say.
Oh well, you know, there's there's plenty of danger of that.
Thanks so much for your time.
My pleasure.
But as far as I can tell, there weren't any new alien types, unless you count a spitting alien as a type, which I thought I saw an alien do that in the movies. And the Pred Alien and Predatorian we've seen before. Shame on you, Tim Jones. And why is this such a big problem? Despite the Xenomorphs having the ability to take on traits of their host, we almost never see that happen. In fact, the only time I've seen it happen was in Alien 3 and those badass Kenner toys from back in the day. Why? I know they do their best to try to stay true to the Geiger artwork, but come on, let's let the aliens evolve. Let's get some new interesting aliens in here. Damn. Essentially what we have here is a developer stuck in 1999, unable or unwilling to produce that ambitious title that we were all hoping for. Instead, what we get is the same old traditional game mechanics in this series that have been around for the past 11 years with stealth kills and predator jumping tacked on. It does stay true to the AVP franchise, and it is definitely a fun ride, but it still has those old school problems. It's as if all of the things that were learned in FPS gaming up till now were ignored. And it's up to you on how you judge that fact. Hardcore fans will obviously love the game. Everybody else will probably just see these older game design flaws. The game is definitely polarizing. You can see it in the review. But what a lot of the reviewers don't mention is multiplayer. And I've said it before, that is the reason to play Aliens vs. Predator games. And this is where the title excels. The multiplayer portion embraces these unique gameplay modes in addition to the old mainstays. Are Species Deathmatch as a Marine team, or Infestation with 18 players. When about 4 or 5 Marines are turned into aliens, all hell breaks loose, and also Survivor Co-op mode for 4 Marine players, which makes me excited about Gearbox's upcoming offering Colonial Marines. I know that game's gonna work. you'll have a lot of fun online. And most of the reviewers completely ignored online, which probably explains some of the lower score. Without it, I'd probably honestly give this game a lot lower score, average or less. However, currently there is a serious issue with multiplayer. If you have more than 12 players in a round, there's only two maps that you can play on, which is utter and it's really putting a serious cap on the fun. They need to seriously open up some of those smaller maps or create more. And also the XP system that unlocks about 6 new skins for your character avatar is kinda lame. How about letting us customize our own avatar as a predator's putting skulls and nets, as marines putting tattoos and equipment and little logos. Or at the very least, give us a Danny Glover skin.
Okay, who's next?
Sold! Or even better yet, an Arnold skin.
Run! Go! This is the chopper! This is the chopper! This is the chopper!
1, 2, 3! Get to the chopper!
Get to the chopper!
You son of a bitch.
Sorry, Arnold. Even though this game hasn't changed for 11 plus years, it shows you the true potential of it all. But now it's time for Rebellion to take that next step and innovate. Which is why I am giving the Aliens vs. Predator game a 7 out of 10. In what appears to be the first game in a desired new franchise, it just doesn't do enough to bring in non-fans for me to give it a higher score, even though God knows I want to. However, if you have any amount of love for Predators, Aliens, or my favorite, the Marines, this is an easy buy. This is a great deal with plenty for your money's worth. 3 campaigns with over 13 hours of gameplay and 7 multiplayer modes that should keep you busy for a while. As for the future Rebellion, you got off lucky this time. I was looking forward to showing up at the office with the smart gun. But guys, maybe Rebellion needs your help. How can they add new, fresh ideas to the sequel, if there is one, without destroying its core? How can they make the Alien campaign more interesting? What other multiplayer modes can we come up with? Maybe playing as a facehugger in a marine extraction mode where you're trying to be evac'd. I'd be more than happy to relay those ideas for you, so leave a comment here, and I'll see you guys on the next Angry Joe Show.
Now move it, people!
All right, sweethearts, you heard the man and you know the drill. Assholes and elbows. Hudson, come here. Come here.